We're at the old army base. Is he hiding out here?
Let me know if there's anything I can do to lighten the load. Or, you know...
Is this the place, huh? Is he in here, boy?
This is it, isn't it? Kellogg's here. All right, Blue. It's you and me. I think dog meat's earned some time off.
Thank you.
Sweet.
bunch of junk.
Sensor reading detected.
Is someone present?
Back down.
visit my old friend, the frozen TV dinner. Last time we met, you were cozying up to the peas and apple cobbler. Sorry, your house has been a wreck for 200 years, but I don't need a roommate. Leave. Never expected you to come knocking on my door. Gave you 50-50 odds of making it to Diamond City. After that, figured the Commonwealth would chew you up like jerky. Pissed off, I get it, I do. But whatever you hope to accomplish in here, it's not gonna go your way.
Sweet.
Always on good behavior, aren't you?
Thank you.
always on good behavior, aren't you? Say the word. Help yourself. Always on good behavior, aren't you?
You always pry this much into the motives of your traveling partners?
Just the ones I find particularly interesting. I appreciate it. Too few folks can be bothered. Of course, in my experience, if you want to do real good, playing nice only gets you so far. I mean, look at Diamond City. A place I've been trying to warn of real danger. But every issue I publish, all I hear is, "Oh, Piper, why don't you ever publish anything happy? Piper, why can't you write something nice for a change?" It's enough to make me want to hang up my hat some days.
Is Diamond City really in danger? It's not like there's raiders pounding on the gate.
Are you kidding me? There is a very real chance the city leadership has been infiltrated by an Institute synth. A synth under the control of an organization widely known to kidnap or murder anyone that stands up to them. I'd take raiders at the gate any day of the week over that. Of course, making sure folks are actually listening. That's a battle in itself.
Why not just give people what they want?
What they want? I'm trying to give people what they deserve. The truth. Sure, it can be scary, knowing what's really out there. A night doesn't go by, I'm not afraid some Institute drone will decide today's the day to pay old Piper and family a visit. But it's worth it. Because I know the truth. That's what protects us.
You'd really risk your family like that?
I'm not saying it's without its consequences. But in my experience, it's worth it. I've seen firsthand what the truth can do. My sister and I, we grew up way out in the Commonwealth. Tiny little settlement. Our dad, he was part of the local militia. Keeping the raiders off our backs and the mire lurks out of our latrines, as he'd describe it. Well, one day, our dad turns up dead. His captain, asshole named Mayburn, claims raiders must have gotten him on watch. Well, I didn't buy it. I start making inquiries. Turns out, the captain, he'd sold out. Thought he wasn't getting paid enough to babysit the town. He was gonna leave the gates open one night, let a group of raiders sack the place and take a cut of the profits. My dad found out and was gonna turn Mayburn in, but Mayburn got to him first. And I wasn't about to let that bastard get away with murder. I tried talking to the mayor, but he wouldn't listen. So, I papered the entire town in posters. Wanted for gross dereliction of duty, Captain Mayburn. The mayor sure wanted to talk after that. The town threw Mayburn out on his ass and were dug in when a very surprised group of raiders finally showed.
What happened after that?
We made do. Sis was still pretty young at the time and Mom was out of the picture. So we got by on the kindness of others for a while. Eventually, I saved up enough to book us both passage with a caravan and then we moved on up to the big city. Called it home ever since.
I'm sorry about your dad.
Thanks. It was hard after he was gone, but knowing that he died doing right, that's always made it easier. But hey, I'm sorry if I've been rambling. I just get fired up sometimes. It's just nice to talk to someone who actually seems to get it, you know? So, should we head out?
Thank you.
Hey.
Where to? Looking for something specific?
Hey.
What can I do? Don't mind the clutter.
Guts and determination. It's admirable. You are in over your head in ways you can't possibly comprehend. Just up ahead. My synths are standing down. Let's talk.
And there she is, the most resilient woman in the Commonwealth. So, here we are. Funny, huh?
You murdering, kidnapping psychopath. Give me my son. Give me Sean, now!
Right to it then, huh? Okay. Fine. Your son, Sean. Great kid. A little older than you may have expected. But I'm guessing you figured that out by now. But if you're hoping for a happy reunion, ain't gonna happen. Your boy's not here.
Fuck you, Kellogg.
Let him go. Your time's done. Your son is exactly where he belongs. He's home. In the Institute.
Here, the Institute. I'll find my son no matter where he is.
That's the spirit. You know, you surprise me, I have to admit. I find myself actually kind of liking you. You might have actually been a good mother. And I admire your dedication, even if it is ultimately useless. But I think we've been talking long enough. We both know how this has to end. So, you ready?
I'm gonna make you suffer. You were barely human.
intentions are peaceful. We are the Brotherhood of Steel.
Assignment.